afternoon baseball here on the show. Ought to be a good one here between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Miami Marlins. Gene Segura standing in, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Now the 1-1 pitch.
The count 2-1.
Grounded to first. He's right there, and he'll take this to the bag himself, and there's your first out of the ball game.
That is tough.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And foul, though it had the home run distance. The 2-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on.
Right. Harper.
Strike three called, and the inning is over. Stepping into the box, Jonathan Villar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's the 1-1. Ball and two strikes now. Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar.
He's up in the zone a lot right now. Sometimes that can be effective, but I think you have to be careful with that, especially during a day game where the ball tends to carry a lot more.
Catch is made out there by McCutchen, and that's the first out. Ready now for the Marlins, Miguel Rojas. His past line against Aaron Nola. He's totaled four hits in 20 at-bats. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. And he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Up next from Miami, Corey Dickerson. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. A 1-1 home. Hit sharply on the ground. And the Marlins had their first hit of the season. He'll get it into second. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Stepping in now, Reese Hoskins. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Chin high, that's taken for a ball. Into the corner and slicing foul. The 2-2 one more time. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. So the base is empty here with one away. And that'll bring up Didi Gregorius. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. Throw just in time as they get him by an eyelash. So bases are empty here with two gone. And in steps the catcher, JT Realmuto. 1-1. It is strike two swinging.
Two strikes.
Got him swinging in the dirt. Alfaro goes to get it, and the throw to first ends the inning. So digging in now, Garrett Cooper. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. The 2-2. Swing and a ball line down in the left field corner. But this will be foul. Here's another 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
It's a fine line from working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance at getting swung at. Right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
Ready now, Brian Anderson. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Here it comes on 1-1. 1-2 now. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now. Bottom of the second here with no score. And there's a base hit on the line. At the plate, Matt Joyce. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. He spoils another one and will do it again. Payoff pitch one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him. So striding forward now, Harold Ramirez. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Taken in by Gregorius. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Nick Williams. 7-8-9, bottom of the order, set to go here in the third. The 1-1. Skied into very shallow right. Ramirez is in a few steps as he takes it for the first down. So one away here with the bases empty. And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Scott Kingery. The 1-1.
Two balls, one strike, the count.
To 2-2 now. Phillies are still looking to crack into the hit column in this one. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. Now the 3-2 pitch. Too high, and that cost him ball four. So a runner on first with one out now, and it'll be the pitcher up next, Aaron Nola. Now a throw over, but the runner's back easily. Kingery, base runner at first with one out. And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. And that'll bring up Gene Segura. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Count is 1-2 now. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Segura is slugging just a little over 400. Not a huge threat, but he can certainly square one up on occasion. And VR will look this one in to retire the side. Settling in now, Jorge Alfaro, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third. The pitcher, Jordan Yamamoto, steps up to the plate in a sacrifice situation, so let's see if that is indeed on right here. And they indeed have the pitcher bunting here as he gets this one down. throw, not in time at first, so the pitcher tries to give himself up, but instead he gets himself a base hit. Digging in, Jonathan Villar. Flied out in his first at bat, so making 0 for 1 so far. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3 and 1.
You fight so hard to get into these type of counts, you can't let this pitch get away from you. You have to keyhole something middle of the plate.
Now the 3-2 pitch. This is swung on and popped up, crossing into foul territory now behind third. And no one will track it down. Here's a weakly hit fly ball off to the left side. McCutchen comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Riding in once again, Miguel Rojas. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
At the plate, Corey Dickerson. Two on, two out for him here in the third. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Here's Andrew McCutchen now, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. So next to the plate for the Phils, Bryce Harper, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
Oh, you have to love it. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low-scoring pitcher's duel for once.
And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes, and the first two are retired here to begin inning number four. The 2-1. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. That gets down, and the Phillies' first hit of the game is going to be for extra bases. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
Now back, third baseman, Didi.
To the plate now, Didi Gregorius. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. And that'll bring in Garrett Cooper. So far, 0 for 1 with a flyout. Popped him up. There to make the catch is Hoskins, and that's the first out of the inning. Now at the plate, Brian Anderson. He reached on a single in his first try. No runs, two hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, Brian. Here's Matt Joyce now.
Number seven.
One-one. Lifted the other way to left center. On the run is Williams. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Digging in, Harold Ramirez. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Lifted in the air out to right. On the move is Harper. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Stepping into the box, JT Realmuto. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Now back, the better fielder, Nick Williams.
Standing in now, Nick Williams. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. A swing, and this ball is blasted to right field. Nothing's gonna keep this one in the ballpark. And that's a home run into the top tank. In now, Scott Kingery. Swing and a line drive, but a foul ball. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. Now the 3-2 pitch. There's ball four. So here now is the pitcher, Aaron Nola. He successfully laid down a sack bunt in his last plate appearance.
And not easy to do in today's game. High velocity, exploding breaking stuff. He executed that sack bunt perfectly.
And with two strikes, he's able to get this one down. And they'll put the tag on him going to first, but the sacrifice is successful. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Gene Segura. Two runs, three hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. This is on the ground over to first. Reined in. And he'll take this one to the bag for the out, but meanwhile the runner will move up 90 feet to third base. So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. Here it comes on 1-1. Slider, more of a slurve right there, but it's 1-2. Swing and a ground ball to third. He's got it. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. Digging in, Jorge Alfaro, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Count even at 2-2 to the Marlins catcher. Skied in the air to straightaway left. McCutchen will get there with ease as he puts it away for out number one. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Jordan Yamamoto. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
Yamamoto.
The 1-1. Misses, ball two.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. And sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Line drive to left, and the pitcher's got himself a base hit. So the lineup card turns over with one away following the base hit out of the pitcher's spot.
The batter, number two, second baseman.
So now to the plate, Jonathan Villar. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Miguel Rojas. Third at bat in this one, he's bounced out and popped out in his two previous trips. In the air down the line and left. McCutchen is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Now to the plate, Bryce Harper. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Right back at him and off his glove. But he is able to recover as he gets the out at first. One away now.
The first
And now it'll be the cleanup spot for the Phillies. Rhys Hoskins, one for two with a double on the ledger so far. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four. Here's Didi Gregorius.
Now batting, third baseman, Didi Gregorius.
Runner, runner, runner. And there he goes towards second. Popped him up. Anderson is under it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Digging in and looking for more, JT Realmuto, a hit in two tries for him so far. Inside, he misses ball four. Big spot here. First and second, two men gone, and digging in at the plate, the Texas native Nick Williams.
Yeah, that last at bat, Daddy, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Now at the plate, Corey Dickerson. He's one for two in this one. And this is low, ball two, two and one. Three and one to the Marlins left fielder.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus.
A dive, and he knocks it down. And a good try to recover that time, but he'll beat it out as he's aboard to kick off the inning. Into the box, Garrett Cooper. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. The 1-2.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this ball is popped up, drifting back behind the mound. Kingery is under it, and he's got it for the first out. So a runner at first now with one away, and that will bring up the outfielder, Brian Anderson.
Anderson.
Swinging a soft liner, and that's in there. Base hit. The throw to third. Throw won't get him.
The center fielder, number seven.
At the plate, Matt Joyce. Strike taken up in the zone. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's two and two now. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Now in the box, Harold Ramirez. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. A 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. This is line to left, and he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Yimi Garcia will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. John Birdie is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Number five, John.
Ready with two balls and a strike.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
Now batting.
Next up will be the Phillies pitcher, Aaron Nola. He laid down a sacrifice bunt in his last trip.
Yeah, he's already shown he can get the job done. Executed flawlessly last time up. Look for the same idea here.
And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection. Runner at second, one away, and that'll bring in the middle infielder Gene Segura. Set to deal on 2-2. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Curveball, but a good job to lay off, and he works out the free pass. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. The 1-2.
Boy, the Phillies have been looking for some offense all game long. They've yet to find it. Let's hope they can find it pretty soon.
The next 1-2 pitch.
I'll tell you, it's a helpless feeling for a manager or a pitching coach when your pitchers are having a really hard time throwing strikes. What are you supposed to do other than keep trying new guys until someone starts attacking the zone?
And that's in there. Base hit. Long throw to third. Stepping in now, Bryce Harper. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Hit back up the middle. Scooped up over to VR. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Leading off the inning, Jorge Alfaro, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. Stepping up to the plate, John Birdie. And he lays off the pitch down and away. Ball two.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Number two, second baseman, Jonathan Villar.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Slice down the left side, but foul. Lofted in the air out toward right center. On the move is Harper. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Sterling Sharp has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 56.
Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Rhys Hoskins. It was a walk in his last trip. The 2-1 home. The swing by Hoskins, and this is driven to deep left. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Into the box now, Didi Gregorius. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. And it's fouled away. Back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first, two gone. Coming to the plate now, JT Realmuto. He enters this at bat, one for two with a walk. The 1-1 home.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1. And a great location that time on the corner, 3-2 now. Now a swing and he pops him up. This is right out in front of the mound. Cooper will put this one away and the side is retired. Striding into the box, Miguel Rojas. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. Oh, and he lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four. Coming to the plate now, Corey Dickerson. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. After it is Williams. He's there and records the first down. Hector Neris answers the call now, looking to get this one onto the ninth inning without any trouble. Garrett Cooper will be the first to greet him here, as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1 down the third baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Line towards center field. Oh, and this kicks right off of him. Into the box now, Brian Anderson. Splitter taken here, 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
He's falling behind now, 3-1.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in the zone, or you just pitch around them?
3-2 pitch. Little chopper back to the mound. And indeed, he'll not even try as he goes to first, and that means two men are in scoring position now with two away. In now, Matt Joyce. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. The 1-1. Line drive. That's a base hit into the right center field gap. And the second run is across to make this a 3-2 ball game now. Francisco Cervelli will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. Runner on first with two away. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2. And that misses, 2-2. Hit out towards second. Kingery's there. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Adam Conley enters from the pen to start the ninth inning, as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Now at the plate, Nick Williams. He went deep back in the fifth. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2. Heading out towards shallow right. Birdie is there, and there's one away. Now at the plate, Scott Kingery.
The second baseman. God.
One run game here in the top of the ninth. Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Alfaro has it, but it's not in time, and he'll reach first despite going down on strikes. Davey Grillon will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Davey Grillon.
Over at the knees, and that's the second strike. It's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? The second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. David Robertson enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 30.
Striding in, Jorge Alfaro. He'll be the one to start things out against David Robertson, who tries to close the door in this one. Now the 3-2 pitch. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. A swing and a shot hit down the corner, and a big sigh of relief on the mound as that nearly tied it, but this ball is foul. Another full count pitch home. Skied into straightaway right. Harper is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. One away. Ready for another chance? John Birdie. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
The 3-1. High in the air out to center field. Williams is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Back to the top of the Miami lineup now, and stepping in, Jonathan Villar. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Ground ball left side. And that's through into left field for a base hit. In now, Miguel Rojas. Pitch is high. The throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. And there's a called strike two, as now they're down to their final strike this afternoon. Miami down to their last strike. Into center field, and that's going to get down for a base hit. And the tying run comes around to score from second. It's a 3-3 game. To the plate now, Corey Dickerson. Strike two swinging just out in front of the slider. Strike three, and the potential winning run laid waste. The inning is over. We are into extra innings. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Gene Segura. It was a walk in his last trip. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Swing and a liner. But this will be taken in out there at short, and that's the first out of the inning. Digging in now, Andrew McCutchen. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat. And he just misses inside with the fastball there. Well, he just threw that fastball by him. Swing and a miss, so a perfect start to the 10th here. Two up and two down.
Now batting.
Here's Bryce Harper now. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. And he strikes him out here for out number three. So after a scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. Sir Anthony Dominguez comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here. So here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Garrett Cooper. He singled his last time up. The 2-1 home. Hit down the line at first, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Now here's the pitch. Again, he sends it out of play. Ready with another 2-2. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. Stepping in, Brian Anderson. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
And I really don't know how you swing at that. He must have had his mind up he was going to swing as soon as the ball came out of the pitcher's hand.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Fouled off. Into the windup. The 2-2 pitch. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Bases are empty here with two men out. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
Wow, talk about a waste pitch on 2-2.
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Eleventh inning set to get underway, so now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Reese Hoskins. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And right into the shift. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2. Didi Gregorius will be next. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. So now to the plate, Didi Gregorius, 0-for-4 with a strikeout thus far. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Now the 2-1 pitch. JT Realmuto is on deck. Set to deal. Here's the 3-1. Swing and a liner. And that's the second out. Plate, JT Realmuto is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. 3-1.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch until he proves he can lay off of it.
And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Standing in, Nick Williams. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. The 1-1 pitch. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. This one's flared toward left center. Here comes Dickerson. But he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. And that's going to move that go-ahead run to second now with two gone. Roman Quinn will be summoned now to be the pinch runner. Standing in now, Scott Kingery, fouled away. The set and the 1-2. In the dirt here. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. He's set. The 2-2. Two men are on with two men out. Line toward the alley in left center. Oh, and it falls as he can't make the play. And the second run will score as well as they grab the lead here at 5-3. Drew Steckenrider is out from the bullpen now as he'll get the call here on opening day. Josh Harrison will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number seven, Josh Harrison.
And he fouls this one off. Trying to keep the game close. Here's the pitch. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And that ends the inning. Jose Alvarez takes the mound in a safe situation as he'll try and make sure this one doesn't reach the 12th. Jesus Aguilar is up off the bench here to start the home half of the 11th as he'll need to get on after that disastrous top of the 11th. Just got the corner that time with a fastball, strike two. Alvarez is among a dying breed, those lefty specialists whose roles are changing with the new rules around reliever usage. And the pinch hitter is retired here, one away. Now digging in once again, Jorge Alfaro. Jorge. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. 1-1.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
Alfaro in front, three balls and a strike. And a fastball misses there, ball four. Into the box now, John Birdie. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch. Runner at first here, one man out. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Hit back toward the mound. Oh, and he can't come up with it. At the plate now, Jonathan Villar. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
And he misses with it, ball four, so that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
Now batter.
So striding in, Miguel Rojas, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? On to first, and it's a double play. A key pitch there with the bases loaded. It winds up stranding the potential tying run at second, and this ball game is over. 5-3, the final score in this afternoon's game. Sir Anthony Dominguez claims the win out of the pen, his first. Jose Alvarez records the save, his first of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Philadelphia Phillies. 5 runs on 5 hits. No errors. They left 9 runners on base. For the Marlins, 3 runs on 10 hits. 1 error. They left 12 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 2 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.